our situation. And so now, precious one, what happens? What happens when you begin to declare logos? That word from God was a sharp, two-edged sword. And so now the Bible lets me know that it passed my intellect, that it passed my doubt, it passed my cognition, it passed my ability to confabulate. In other words, to put one thought in front of the other. Now God's word superseded that. He is insurmountable. He is indubitable. He is above everything that ever was. But before I can go there, and he has now given me a word called logos. As you meditate on rhema or on the logos, it will quicken you. It quickens you, and suddenly its power is released inside of your very being. And now you got to tell somebody about it. Whenever the logos fits a situation, that's why logos has got to be experienced. Are you still here? You can't just preach it without experiencing it. Before I got up here, I had to go through something. I can't tell you that logos will keep you in a bad or in a hot situation, but that logos will cool you off. If I've never been in a hot situation where logos had to come in and take a deep breath and cool me off. Are y'all still in the room? I cannot tell you that logos now can heal you from being sick. If somebody had never felt the power, if I had never felt the power of illness in my body, are you still here? I can't tell you now that God can keep you from temptation if sin never lied at my door, creeping, crouching down at my door. If I had never slammed the door in the devil's face, I couldn't tell you that you are able to do just that. But logos has got to be experienced. And once you experience logos, then you can release logos. Let me get out of here because y'all want to go. I can feel it. She's got the degree. She got the understanding of the job. She knows the job. She's there to even be requalified for the job. But you got the edge. You got the edge. Praise God. Now when logos goes out of the mouth of God, that's why it was a two-edged sword in his mouth. That is one edge. And it is the edge all by itself. But God wants to hear the word of God. Thank you. engrafted. Yeah. And once it gets rooted and down inside of you, grounded on the inside of your spirit, now it is taking form. It is uniting with the word of God. The word of God now is about to come out of your mouth. I gotta go because I know y'all want to go. I come to tell you, beloved, that this year is 2011. 11 is one.
Yeah.
You gotta know